way the government is trying to bring in through integrated reporting. Even if you see the United Nations says the climate change is seen to be a greater crisis. It is a crisis. So why it is happening is to be isolated. Next, there is always a link between reporting and economy. हम कहते ना कि GDP like sir कह रहे थे, संदीप जी ने कहा कि GDP जब बनती है, corporate income is a major source. If some companies are doing well, if certain sector is doing well, even in sectors we say iron and steel is an infrastructure or a core sector. So you will see when a core sector is not doing well, पूरी की industry की जो growth है, वो एक जगह stagnant हो जाती है. So there is an essential link between reporting and how your economy measures up. Third, I will not name the companies, but kahin na kahin we have lost trust. Enron was only the starting phase. PNB is still happening today, even after Sarbanes-Oxley, Clause 49, SEBI LODR, we have so many committees, we have independent directors, but still PNB did happen. And why only PNB? Even after that, there was one more issue on banking fraud. So, kahin na kahin, I think, as investors, even when you buy a product, say you buy a simple soap. 5 years back, Lal matlab light boy hi hai, Colgate matlab, isme kya dekhna? I mean, every brush hi to karna hai. But nowadays, I am sure, when you even buy a soap or a toothpaste, you look behind what is the ingredient, kab bana hai, the concept of expiry date. 10 years back, tell me, ma'am, did you ever look for an expiry date on your bread or milk? Tha hi nahi concept. Kab ka doodh hai, bas laaye hain, ubalo aur pee jao. But today we are so oriented that these details are very relevant for us. So kahin na kahin we have lost trust, and that's the reason we go in for looking for more and more information. When we used to receive balance sheets 10 years back, who would look at the resolutions? Who would read the balance sheet? But today, even if you don't understand, and if unfortunately, in my family, amongst all my brothers, I am the only one who's a CS. My father was a chartered accountant. My brother-in-law is a CA. So, ghoom phir ke ye hota hai, yaar, ye batana kya hai? Ye dividend itna kyun aaya? So, unfortunately, wo to nahi padhte hain. But people like us get into the net and we are asked questions, ki ye kyun hai, wo kyun hai. So there is a lack of trust that happens. Next, the background, till today, if you see your books also, I'm sure your books would not have something called non-financial disclosures. Because most of the decision makings in India are made on financial disclosures only. Ki bhai, meri company ne itna profit kiya. So then only I'll give dividend. Then only I'll increase the salary. But Lala company setups mein jao, because I've worked with Lala companies, typical Lala companies, desi companies. The company was never making a profit. And the company wanted to have a succession planning. So basically kya tha? The Ambani stories. He had two sons. Unko demerger ke through puri business ko divide karna tha. I was hired for that purpose from Calcutta, and I was told ki aapko humare hotel mein rehna, it's a 5-star hotel. Sab kuch milega, bas the only thing is 6 mahine aap ghar nahi jaoge. To I said, theek hai ji, 5-star hotel mein khana pina sab kuch, and all my friends were like, ye kaise hoge? Nobody knew the underlying clause in my agreement. And then I realized ki what they actually wanted is, when you go through a demerger, you understand the family values. You cannot do a demerger of a family asset without understanding what is the relation between father and son. What is the relation he shares with his grandson. So, bahut si cheezon ko humne dekha, and then we realized that we should work in a way wherein non-financial elements are more prevalent. It is a real life example. Even today, when you look at a company, you look at the public image. How many of you have read the balance sheet of Infosys? Kitne logon ne? Main to nahi padhta. But whenever I ask anybody, say you are given a job for 20,000 rupees in Infosys and you are given a job for 40,000 rupees in a desi company. Which company will you choose? Kyun? Goodwill. Narayan Murthy. Humne bhi jab CS kiya tha, we wrote papers on Narayan Murthy and corporate governance, but now, you know, even in Tata they have Cyrus episode and Infosys maybe they have episodes. But then there is a trust factor. And how did it happen? It all happened because Infosys started as a small company and it was a husband and wife promoted company, if I'm not right, right? So they had trust, they had family values. And based on that, they built a empire. But that somehow is no longer happening. The next background of bringing in integrated reporting was ESG. Wo ek ad aati na, ECG, engine, clutch and gear, something like that only. Aaj ke date pe ESG is engine, clutch and gear of a corporate entity. E, environment, social and governance issues. तो ये तीन चीज को आप जब इंटीग्रेट करते हो ओनली देन यू कैन अप्लाई योर ब्रेन्स इन चूजिंग वेदर दैट कंपनी इज गोइंग टू सस्टेन और नॉट. इन द मॉर्निंग यू नो आई वाज जस्ट थिंकिंग कि ये सस्टेनेबिलिटी कॉन्सेप्ट इज अ वेरी फैशनेबल वर्ड, सस्टेनेबल सस्टेनेबल, बट हाउ डू यू एक्सप्लेन इट टू अ गैदरिंग ऑफ पीपल लाइक इन बनस्थली हु आर ऑलरेडी वेल इन्फॉर्म्ड. बट एक होता है ना, देयर इज ऑलवेज अ डिस्कनेक्ट बिटवीन information and something that is a corporate jargon. The best example was what Sandeep ji had given regarding Rani Rashmini. What did she do? I mean, I'm not going back into what was the psychological reason, but what did she do? She built temples, she gave employment, she protected the right of people, she built a road. So what is it? It is actually creating a township. आज के डेट पे यू जस्ट थिंक ऑफ दैट मेंटालिटी एंड टेक इट टू जमशेदपुर. वॉट इज जमशेदपुर? जमशेदपुर इज द ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एंड द करंट एग्जाम्पल वॉट रानी राजमणि डिड सम टाइम बैक, है ना? सो इट इज अ कॉर्पोरेट थॉट प्रोसेस वेर इन यू हैव एनवायरमेंटल इशूज, सोशल इशूज एंड गवर्नेंस इशूज. सो दैट बेसिकली इज द सस्टेनेबल मॉडल. रानी राजमणि back in 1700 or whatever the year was, she knew that in order to survive, she has to take care of environmental issues, social issues, and governance issues. So this is basically sustainability. Now tell me, do you think CSR reporting actually has an impact? And I'll give you a hint. See, as a company secretary, we all know that there's a section in Companies Act, sir would also know, section 135. It has been glorified. CSR, CSR karke hume pagal kar liya gaya. When it came in, it was simply on the basis of comply or explain. Because CSR is something which you cannot impose, right sir? I mean, kisi ki bhalai karni hai. Jaise, I mean, I've seen it, I've been to Mumbai, I unfortunately gave somebody 5 rupees. To the beggar said, ke, sir, 10 rupees to do. सो आई सेड कि चलो ठीक है, मुंबई है, मैं मान लेता हूँ अच्छे स्टैंडर्ड्स होंगे. बट इन सी एस आर इज जस्ट लाइक दैट, इट्स अ ह्यूमन जेस्चर, यू कैन नॉट क्रिएट स्टैंडर्ड्स. बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली इट इज मूविंग टू दैट डायरेक्शन. सो कंप्लाई और एक्सप्लेन इज नो लॉन्गर देयर, एंड इफ यू डोंट कंप्लाई यू आर समवेयर गोइंग टू बी पेनलाइज्ड. बट इज दैट द रियल इम्पैक्ट वी आर लुकिंग आउट फॉर? पेनल्टी, वायलेशन, प्रोसिक्यूशन, आपको क्या लगता है कि वो पेनलाइज एक बार कर दे तो वो next time they'll comply? So CSR non-compliance has a greater impact. I took a real life story, Volkswagen. 2015 mein what happened was, they brought in Vento and the diesel version of Vento. So Volkswagen is a Germany based company, European hai, so they wanted to get into the American market. इंडिया में भी वेंटो बहुत बिकती है. आई ऑल्सो पर्सनली लाइक दैट कार, के 11 लाख में इतनी अच्छी कार. एंड जर्मनी, आई मीन उनकी मशीनरी हमेशा रोबस्ट होती है. आई मीन व्हेन यू कंपेयर अ जापानीज मशीनरी विद अ जर्मन मशीनरी, इट्स वेरी रोबस्ट, लॉन्ग लास्टिंग, गिव्स यू व्हाट इट प्रोमिसेस. एंड दैट वॉज द ट्रेडमार्क विद विच इट एंटर्ड इन टू US. अनफॉर्चुनेटली जैसे हम पोल्यूशन टेस्ट कराते हैं, US में भी दे हैव वेरी हाई पोल्यूशन ग्रेडिंग टर्म्स. And this version of Vento, diesel version, had a न्यू डिवाइस कॉल्ड डिफीट डिवाइस. अब ये डिफीट डिवाइस डिफीट किस चीज को करता था? इट डिफीटेड द पोल्यूशन नॉर्म्स इन यूएस. व्हाट डिड इट डू? व्हेनेवर अ कार यूज्ड टू गो फॉर अ पोल्यूशन टेस्ट, इट सिंपली शोड दैट द पोल्यूशन रिकॉर्ड्स वेर ऑप्टिमल. इट वॉज डिफीटिंग द पर्पज ऑफ पोल्यूशन टेस्ट इन यूएस. एंड इन द सेम ईयर 2015, like Mr. Ghosh had said, ke in European countries there are two layers of board, the supervisory board and then you have the functional board. So in 2015, the supervisory board and the board of directors were certifying in their annual report that we are the most sustainable automotive company in the world. Ye nahi world famous in India, nahi, they were world famous in world only. They said ke bhai hum to duniya ke sabse acche companies mein se, and sustainable minded. ये जो हम पोल्यूशन नॉर्म्स को डिफीट कर रहे हैं, दैट इज सस्टेनेबिलिटी, एंड दे हैड कंफर्मड इट इन देयर एनुअल रिपोर्ट. सो ऑन वन हैंड दे आर इंस्टॉलिंग अ डिफीट डिवाइस एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड दे आर सर्टिफाइंग दिस. सो व्हाट कुड बी द इम्पैक्ट? द इम्पैक्ट हैपेंड, व्हाट इज देयर द लास्ट टू लाइन्स, द इम्पैक्ट वॉज लॉस ऑफ फेथ. एग्जैक्टली, सर ने तो नहीं बोला फेथ अपने. Chalo. Any other words? I mean, you know, faculties are disqualified, I would not say. But
-5.
Nahin, I mean, their views are reserved. Anybody from you, what did they lose? I mean, what did Volkswagen lose apart from faith? Kya lagta hai? As a human being, batao. Trust is faith. Usi ka